All right, folks, welcome back at 7:43 right now. Breaking news that we've been following. So far this morning, fire crews have fought three fires here in the valley.
A major one is still burning at Maryland Parkway and Desert Inn this morning. Fox 5's Mike Doria, he is on scene right now. And Mike, last time we checked with you a couple of minutes ago, this was still going strong. What's going on now?
Well, it's still definitely going strong, but they have made some progress with this. The wind seems to die down and then pick back up. So basically, they don't know what they're going to get from minute to minute, but we can tell you that smoke has calmed down a lot. Now, we can also report, thankfully, this morning that everybody has been evacuated out of the apartment building. It's the Rainwalk Apartments. It's over on Dumont and Cambridge Streets, right in the area of Desert Inn and Maryland Parkway. But everybody's been evacuated. Nobody has been hurt. This has now been upgraded to a three-alarm fire. And what that basically means, the higher the alarm, the more firefighters you have on scene. 75 firefighters are on this fire trying to tackle those flames and get it put out. The building, we can tell you, obviously an older one. It's about three stories high. We don't know exactly how many apartments are in this particular building. If I had to guess, maybe 50 or 60. But again, that's something we'll have to find out later. The roof in the middle, if it is all connected straight on back, meaning without a courtyard in the middle, it has collapsed. But again, you can see that smoke now picking back up, and that is one of the trouble spots for the firefighters this morning, because the winds are so strong that every time they get these flames out, a lot of hot spots in it that keep picking right back up. But again, avoid this area, because certainly there is way too much going on, and firefighters need all the room they can get. They're pretty much on three sides of the building, because on that fourth side, there is another apartment building. It's part of the same complex, but they just can't get to it from that spot. But the winds this morning, again, very strong, and they carry these flames over four different rooftops as you see this building sort of go back. We don't know if it has spread to any of the other businesses that are in the surrounding area. We know there's a Wells Fargo Bank right here, a Subway in the plaza that's on the other side of that building, and certainly a lot of trees that you can see here, some now obviously damaged by the fire. But again, firefighters certainly have their work cut out for them. You've got just these two on the ladder right here, and all they have been doing is spraying those flames, and that's all they have been doing for at least the last half hour, making some progress, but not as much as they would like at this point. Heidi and Jason.
All right, Mike, you mentioned something about the fact that the building is older, and you could tell. You could just tell by looking at it. It's an older building. You just wonder if that makes it any harder for firefighters, because sometimes the older buildings aren't, I guess, as advanced when it comes to fireproof, fireproofing.
Yeah, depending on the the building, certainly the newer buildings have much more strict fire code than the older ones. There's firewalls in the newer buildings. One of the fires I was on earlier this morning had what's called a party wall, and basically that's where all the utilities go, and so it's more of a hollow wall, and the fire started in there. We don't know if it's the same case in this building, but obviously it's an older building. The good thing is there's a lot of brick in this building, you can see, but obviously the roof has collapsed on part of it, so it's unclear where the fire started at this point, how it even started. But firefighters, first and foremost, want to get these flames under control. The good news, again, to report this morning and to recap, everybody evacuated out of that building, all safe. We don't know about any pets, though, and certainly a lot of neighbors are saying cats were jumping up over the wall to try and get away from this fire. And as far as evacuations go, perhaps there's people over on Dumont and Cambridge that have been evacuated, because that's the direction that the smoke is going, and certainly makes it very difficult to breathe and see over there. Even more difficult for firefighters to see what they're doing as they try and put these flames out. So hopefully the wind will stay died down. Right now it's okay, but any second it could pick back up.
Well, and Mike, it's far too early to know exactly what caused this, but we know this time of the year there are candles, there are lights on trees and on houses. So whether that caused it or not, it's a good reminder to just keep an eye on those things and don't leave home with candles burning, with the tree still lit.
Space heaters, yeah. Things like that.
Yeah, and especially if you live in an apartment building where you've got a lot of neighbors, it's not just your house, and this is certainly the result if that's how it started. And you can see it's a lot of work for firefighters. Again, they've been on three fires this morning, so good job to both the Las Vegas Fire Department and the Clark County Fire Department.
Okay.
And good point, Jason. The space heaters, it's definitely a lot colder than we've seen in the past couple of days, so I would be surprised people taking those out. You know, again, we don't know what caused this, but it's a good reminder.
All right, Mike, thanks.
Thank you, Mike. Well,
and to Las Vegas now, the site of an explosion in the parking lot of the Luxor Hotel and Casino right on the Strip. Cops are saying the blast was intentional. One man was killed, one narrowly avoided injury. Mike Doria from Fox affiliate KVVU joins us live. Mike, what's the very latest? What do they think happened here?
Well, they're still not sure what kind of motive is behind all of this, at least if they do know, they're not telling us. We can tell you the parking garage behind me on lockdown as this place is packed with security. No one allowed in or out. Do want to take your viewpoint, though, up to the top of the garage. A couple of security cameras that you can see from here. Police obviously going to be using those and seeing what kind of evidence they can grab from those cameras and hopefully seeing if a suspect does appear on that camera putting that bomb on top of the employee's car. Here's what we know so far. It was about 4:11 this morning when two employees left work at the Luxor Hotel. They were not working at the hotel, but either one of the shops or restaurants in the hotel. As they made it to their car, the one male employee realizes there's some sort of suspicious device on top of his car. He doesn't think twice. He grabs that device. That's when police say it exploded. He was rushed to the hospital with very severe burns and a brain injury. He later died at the hospital. The other employee that was with him, and police won't say whether it was a male or a female, that person was not hurt, and certainly police are going to be questioning that person to get a little bit of a better idea of why this one employee thought this device was okay to grab. Unclear right now what kind of device it was. They're not being very specific on what it looked like, so perhaps that's why this employee did grab it, not thinking twice about it. You know, you also got to factor in it's Las Vegas. People get drunk, they start goofing around here on the strip. Perhaps that employee thought somebody just left something stupid on top of his car, and that's why he went to grab it. At this point, though, police still on top of that garage investigating. They say they're going to be here for the next several hours as they sort of piece together. But again, we don't know the motive at this point, and we don't know what kind of beef this employee had with this suspect, or whether this employee thought that this beef was deep enough to where this person would want him killed. Again, a lot of unanswered questions this day, but we do know one person dead after a bomb explodes that was on top of this employee's car inside the Luxor garage. Martha?
Doria, KVVU. Thank you very much for that report, Mike.
Police say a combination of dumb actions by two Valley mothers is enough to make any parent's stomach turn.
Oh, several children came flying out of the car as it makes a turn. The woman behind the wheel busted for DUI. And Mike Doria is live on the scene right now. Mike, I tell you what, listening to this, I can hear the rant is going to go nuts today, I'm sure. But it just makes my stomach turn as a parent.
Yeah, just a bizarre set of details, all circumstances which could have been prevented if certain choices weren't made. This car, 10 people packed inside of it. It was a PT Cruiser, in other words, a roller skate riding down the road. Three of those kids went flying out of the car. None of them restrained. Making matters worse, there were open containers of alcohol inside the car, and one of the women arrested busted for DUI. Well, she is Nancy Lopez, the other Vanessa Ramirez, and both are going to be before a judge in just a matter of moments. This all taking place on Sunday at Bruce and Owens. According to an eyewitness, this car was making a turn. As it was turning, somehow the door opened. Three of those kids went flying out. One of them was a three-year-old. The other two 14-month-old twins. An eyewitness saw the whole thing and said he couldn't believe that none of these kids were killed, if not from hitting that pavement, but from getting struck by a car.
As soon as I looked up, I saw the three bodies of these infants and babies just go tumbling 10 to 15 feet clear across two lanes of traffic. It was horrible. You know, if parents would have seen what I saw with my eyes that night, they would make sure the children are restrained before they even put the car in drive.
Well, again, that car not big enough to hold all those children, certainly not enough seat belts. The driver, 28-year-old Nancy Lopez, before a judge right now, admitted to an officer that she had 3.5, maybe 4 beers, was stumbling as she got out of the car. When she went over to sit on the curb, police had to inform her of what was going on, obviously, and she said, I'm going to jail, right? To which the cop said, you do know that your children are in critical condition. She said, oh. As far as the other woman, she was talking to CPS and said that she knew full well that Nancy Lopez was drunk, but did nothing to stop her from getting behind the wheel with those kids in the car.
Man, people just had to use some better judgment, for sure. It's an understatement. But
what I really want to say, I can't even say on TV. Yeah. Mike, thank you.
All right, this time you go down the strip, you might see a new attraction with strippers on wheels.
Yeah, it's all a part of a new ad campaign from a local strip club. Fox 5's Mike Doria is live at Deja Vu Strip Club with the detail. Mike.
Oh, no.
Good morning, Monica and Jason.
You know what? That needs to go on YouTube. That was pretty good.
Mike, that is supposed to be to set up lights, not for you to act as a stripper pole.
You know, Jason, in these tough times, I couldn't afford a stripper pole, so a stripper light stand had to do.
All
just
right.
The problem is you can move it all around.
Oh, brother.
Not the sturdiest of stripper poles, but, you know, I'm going to set this aside here for a minute. And be more serious, the credible journalist that I am, but apparently all the flashing lights outside of the strip club and all the women inside flashing boobs just wasn't enough to lure customers. So they had to think inside the box and basically find a new way to advertise the strip club. And now they're doing that inside of a box on the strip. Happens at every live shot. The stripper mobile, if that's what we'll call it, is just what you might expect. It looks like a box on wheels with windows on all sides and half-naked women inside finding the best pole position. Their job is simply to entice locals and tourists with time on their hands and those with some TNA on their minds to go inside the club. And the advertising basically has worked, as you'll hear from the marketing director of Deja Vu.
Just last night, we had a double stretch Hummer limo come in, followed us from the strip with 20 customers in it. So, you know, it's doing its job. We wanted to come up with something fun that was, interesting and exciting for, you know, the tourist.
Well, fun for some, but a bit much for others. Some locals and tourists say that kids don't need to see women dancing around inside of a car on the strip. However, most of the driving does take place at night at time when the little ones are asleep and the double Ds want to come out and play. And Deja Vu's show on the strip is PG, meaning the women are fully clothed, much like what you wouldn't expect of them inside the club. So basically, some harmless advertising and some unique advertising at that. Probably would only work here in Vegas, Monica and Jason.
Yeah, I imagine so, Mike.
Yeah, I guess Monica brought up a good point. You can see that, oh boy. You can see that on the strip anyway, I guess, if you're walking. The problem is when that like truck, you know, like leaves the strip to go back to its business.
Yeah.
And it's like getting through neighborhoods. Mommy,
well,
the ice
Jason,
cream
it's
truck.
Not like the... Yeah, like the ice cream truck. I'm sure that the women stopped dancing. You know, they're not rolling through a country club as a shortcut.
But why let reality ruin a good vision?
Thank you, Mike. Thanks for the dance,
too. Yeah.
7:36 right now. Is it Friday?
Yeah.
Okay, driver.